My life has been about resilience. Somebody who was born with a polio and was a cripple. In 2002, when the anti-Muslim riots took place in India, I went as a relief worker. I was 19, and that's when my life changed and I decided to be a journalist. I told my parents that I'm going for a trekking trip with my friends. We collected some relief material, took a train, entered Gujarat, went to the relief camps. Saw women raped in relief camps.
I saw the suffering. I saw 1,000 Muslim lives taken away while Narendra Modi was literally meters away and he did not stop it.
I had goosebumps all over my body. I would cry, I would break down because their helplessness reminded me of my own helplessness.
Modi, who's now the Prime Minister of India, he had got away completely unscathed from the entire investigation.
That injustice had to be exposed. I went undercover because I had to expose Mr. Narendra Modi, his role in the genocide of Muslims, his and his minister's role in the extrajudicial murder of Muslims.
Rana Ayub, a prominent investigative journalist and columnist from India and a vital voice in South Asia, covering politics and social issues, justice and state crimes.
Women investigative journalists. Across the board, we have trolling, whataboutery, fake news, which has been normalized, and we have seen this more often.
I know some days it can be really daunting, especially the rape and death threats for which the United Nations Special Rapporteurs wrote to the Indian government to protect my safety. Of course, right. The Indian government did not react to it. The kind of trolling that I receive and the kind of hate that I receive, it basically reflects on the fact that my work is hurting them where it should hurt.
I think that's what keeps me going. The idea of justice keeps me going.
Every decision that this government has been taking, every bill that the government wants to pass in the Indian Parliament is anti-Muslim in essence and spirit.
And this is not something that happened overnight. It has been building up over days and weeks.
I have never witnessed anything more traumatizing than what I have been witnessing right now as a journalist in India.
When the people feel that they are being treated as animals, they are not being given their basic human rights, that their voice is not being heard by the rest of the world.
I am pushing back by speaking the truth, a truth that is extremely unpopular and unpalatable for the government.
I know they won't like it, but I have to keep showing them the mirror. This is how ugly it is. There are people who are out in the streets who have nowhere to go. These are Muslims with identities, with beards and skull caps. They can be attacked and they have no one. These are the people I fear for. I fear for the women of India who are being raped and who are being attacked. I fear for the lower caste of India who are being lynched too, just like Muslims are being lynched. I love the Indian democracy, but the soul of the Indian democracy has been attacked by this Prime Minister.
Why are we electing people like Narendra Modi to power? Somewhere we have lost our moral compass as citizens of the country. The people who elect Putin, the people who elect Trump, these are the people who need to answer those questions, not the institutions.
As a journalist, and I believe history will be kind and objective to journalists who stuck to what they were doing, I think under Modi's rule is the best time to be a journalist in India. The journalism that we are doing is a backlash against the backlash.
And when you see the injustice around you, move out of the country, it's the easiest thing to do. But to stay back in your own country and fighting for what is right and fighting for your own people, that keeps your faith alive.